Welcome students to my YouTube channel Bharat Chem Study. Today we are going to study about chapter 6, study of the first element hydrogen for the 9th standard of ICC board. In this video part 2, we are going to study about activity series and its application, displacement of hydrogen from dilute acids by reactive metals with examples. Let's start with the video. Activity series. The arrangement of metal in the decreasing order of their reactivity from top to bottom is called activity series. The activity series can be represented as कल्लू नाथ का मैनेजर आलू जरा फीके बताता है क्योंकि हरी आगे पटना आएगा. That we already have studied in our previous chapter chemical reactions. Now the important information conveyed by the activity series. First, the metal present above hydrogen in the activity series are most reactive. Higher the metal present above in the activity series, higher is the reactivity. For example, here potassium is present at the top of the activity series, so it is highly reactive. Then sodium, then calcium, then magnesium, then zinc, and the reactivity decreases down the series up to hydrogen. Then further, the metal which are less reactive even than hydrogen are placed below. Metal above hydrogen produce hydrogen gas on reaction with dilute acids. For example, when sodium react with HCl, it produces NaCl and hydrogen gas. Reactivity of metal depends on the activity series with water that we already have studied in the previous video, but we are recapitulating it again. That potassium and sodium react vigorously with cold water to form hydrogen gas, and the reaction is so exothermic that the hydrogen gas formed catches fire. So they are kept in kerosene oil to avoid their contact with the moisture present in air, and the reaction can be represented as sodium react with water to form NaOH and hydrogen gas. Similarly, potassium react with water to form KOH and hydrogen gas. It's very important to balance the chemical equation. Second point, calcium also reacts vigorously with cold water but do not catch fire, and the equation is calcium reacts with two molecules of water to form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Magnesium reacts very slowly with water but vigorously with warm water and burn in steam. So there are two equations we already have studied. When magnesium reacts with boiling water, then it forms magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. But when magnesium reacts with steam, it forms magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas. This is very important to note down. Aluminium, zinc, iron react with steam, and iron react when it is red hot form to form their respective oxide and hydrogen gas. So the equation for the aluminium is aluminium react with steam to produce aluminium oxide and hydrogen. Zinc also react with steam to form zinc oxide and hydrogen, but iron react with steam only when iron is red hot and it gives Fe3O4, which is a mixed oxide, and hydrogen gas is formed. Again, the balancing is very important. So you have to practice yourself for the balancing of chemical equations. The metal below hydrogen do not react with water or even with steam due to their less reactivity. The next point is lead and other metals below in the reactivity series do not react with water, even with hot water or steam, due to their less reactivity. Hydrogen, though a non-metal, is included in the activity series because it can also have a tendency to lose electron and to form positive ion like metals. The reactivity of metals present in the activity series with dilute acids, so these are very important equations. First point, potassium and sodium react vigorously with dilute acid like HCl or dilute H2SO4 to form hydrogen gas, and the equation can be represented as two atoms of sodium react with two molecules of HCl to form two molecules of NaCl and hydrogen gas. And similarly, two atoms of potassium react with two molecules of HCl to give two molecules of KCl and hydrogen gas. Similarly, sodium and potassium on reaction with sulfuric acid gives sodium sulfate and hydrogen gas. Similarly, potassium on reaction with dilute sulfuric acid gives potassium sulfate and hydrogen gas is formed. Second point, calcium and magnesium react less vigorously with dilute acid, and reaction can be represented as calcium plus HCl give rise to calcium chloride and hydrogen gas, or calcium react with dilute sulfuric acid to give calcium sulfate and hydrogen gas is formed. Similarly, magnesium react with dilute HCl to give magnesium chloride and hydrogen, and with dilute sulfuric acid, magnesium gives magnesium sulfate and hydrogen gas. Aluminium has great affinity towards oxygen, So a protective layer of its oxide is formed with over it, which stops its further reaction with acid. So it reacts slowly with dilute acids, and the reaction can be represented as aluminium reacts with dilute HCl to form aluminium chloride and hydrogen gas. Similarly, aluminium reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to give aluminium sulfate and hydrogen gas. Do practice of balancing the chemical equations. Next point, zinc and iron react easily with dilute HCl and dilute sulfuric acid to form hydrogen gas. Iron reacts with dilute HCl to give FeCl and hydrogen. And similarly, iron reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to give FeSO4 and hydrogen. Zinc reacts with dilute HCl to give zinc chloride and hydrogen. And similarly, zinc reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to give zinc sulfate and hydrogen. Next point, the metal below hydrogen do not react with dilute or concentrated acids. Copper is present below hydrogen in the reactivity series. Therefore, it is unable to displace hydrogen from dilute acids, and therefore when copper is added to dilute HCl or sulfuric acid, no reaction will take place. Important points, nitric acid and hot concentrated sulfuric acid are not used in the preparation of hydrogen. The question arises why? The answer is, nitric acid is not used because it is a powerful oxidizing agent and it oxidizes the hydrogen form to water. Hence, they defeat the purpose of the reaction. Similarly, the hot and concentrated sulfuric acid is not used as it produces sulfur dioxide during its reaction instead of hydrogen gas. Zinc is preferred over other metal in the lab preparation of hydrogen due to the following reason. First, potassium and sodium react violently with acids and sometimes they explode. That's why they are not used. Calcium and magnesium are not used because they are expensive. Aluminium form a protective layer of aluminium oxide due to its strong affinity towards oxygen. Hence, aluminium does not give hydrogen properly with acids. Iron has to be heated to produce hydrogen gas, but the hydrogen gas formed by iron contains impurities like H2S and sulfur dioxide. Therefore, it is not used. Lead react with dilute acid and form an insoluble layer of lead sulfate or lead chloride, which prevent further reaction. Therefore, lead is also not used for the preparation of hydrogen. Other metal like copper plays below in the activity series and do not give hydrogen gas with dilute acids. Displacement of hydrogen from alkali, that is the reaction of alkalis with metals like aluminium, zinc and lead, or unique nature of these elements that we already have studied also in the previous video of chemical reaction chapter. Zinc, aluminium and lead has a unique feature that they can react with dilute acid as well as strong alkalis to give salt and hydrogen gas. That's why they are said to have a unique feature. For example, zinc react with HCl to produce zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Similarly, zinc can react with strong alkali like NaH or pOH to form sodium zincate salt having the formula Na2ZnO2 and produce hydrogen gas. So this is the unique property of zinc, aluminium and lead, that they can react with acid as well as with the alkalis and give salt and hydrogen gas. Similarly, zinc react with potassium hydroxide to give potassium zincate and hydrogen gas can be formed. Similarly, lead react with NaH to give sodium plumbite and hydrogen gas. Lead can also react with pOH to give potassium plumbite and hydrogen gas. Similarly, zinc can react with fused NaOH to give sodium aluminate with the formula Na3AlO3 and hydrogen gas. But when aluminium reacts with boiling NaOH in the presence of water, that's very important to write water here, then the product form is sodium meta-aluminate with the formula NaAlO2 and hydrogen gas. Similarly, aluminium can react with boiling pOH in the presence of water to give potassium meta-aluminate and hydrogen gas. So these equations are very much important because they are also coming in your 10th standard. Learn and note down all the important points and chemical equations for the reactions of metal with dilute acid as well as with alkalis. Practice the chemical equations. In next video, we will study the preparation and collection of hydrogen gas in the laboratory and industrial manufacture of hydrogen by Bosch process. Please like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.